Hey, welcome back to Stoneblock. I ran into a bit of a problem this week with Stoneblock, which is that I felt like playing it. I felt like playing it, and that's not a good thing. Because if I feel like playing the game, then the game ends up being something that I evolve too much. I replaced my ladders with elevators because it just made it a little bit faster. Set up a whole bunch of stuff that I ended up having to break a bunch of times. I got rid of my trees. I set up a system so that every time a chicken lays something, it goes to these walls. For the most part, that's things organized. Now, oh wait, bones go up there. Now I need to actually look into stuff. What should I be doing? Wait a minute. I didn't get this? Infusion crystal. And then here's my really nice one. Those are quick. This is something I have not started yet, because I've not had any reason to do it. I might be able to go ahead and actually do stuff with this one. I just need to make a Draconic Evolution information tablet. Ah, there we go. Did not take way too long. Oh, that would have been a lot fucking faster if I'd looked right here. There's all the stone, and there we go. Now, what the hell is this thing? Oh, fuck. It's a giant menu book. I think I can probably just figure out from the flow chart here what needs to be done next. I hope I can anyway. It looks fairly obvious. Let's start off with the armor, because you can see I'm not wearing great armor. I could use some that's actually helpful. That shit's gonna require nether stars. Alright, well that ain't happening. The advanced dislocator requires me to actually make stuff. The dislocator unbound, I can make that now. Since this requires me to make one, I might as well go ahead and do that real quick. Blaze powder. Eye of Ender. This sounds like I'm making a magic potion. I don't have the ability to do that without fusion crafting, so that's going to take a while. Right, I'm going to have to build an entire fusion setup, I guess. That's the next step for the day. Well, at least I remember how to do that. And there we go. That's my setup. It needs power. I do not know how I'm going to do power other than maybe shoving a generator behind every one of these. God, okay. You know what? I made it so that I could actually get these. I just have to get vibrant alloy. And vibrant alloy, that ain't too hard. It'd probably be faster if I made vibrant alloy chickens. That ain't something that I can do right now, so I probably ought to just make vibrant alloy chickens off the side. I can, however, because I've got shitloads of ender pearls. I can make that vibrant alloy pretty easy, I think. I just need energetic alloy first. Alright. This setup does seem to work. Drains all the power out of this fucking draconium generator when I hook it up to things. These say zero RF, but that's because they have to build power while they're actually making a thing. I can't do the basic fusion crafting thing. I can do basic. I cannot turn it into the Wyvern one yet because I don't have nether stars, but that means that this basic setup is completed. Damn it. Everything requires that I get nether stars. I gotta kill Withers to get anything done, I think. That's gonna be real hard to do. God damn it. I was hoping I could just go ahead and get some of this stuff done. Mob grinder. I don't think that's hard to do. Mob grinder I've got done. That's easy enough. Above that is a stabilized mob spawner. How the fuck? That requires a broken mob spawner, which means I have to find a broken spawner. That shit ain't gonna happen. I'm gonna have to find a mob spawner. That ain't something I can just find. That's probably hanging out somewhere in the mining dimension. Looks like, with basic fusion crafting complete, this is probably done. I'm going to have to get a bunch more chickens, otherwise I'm not going to have the materials to make anything else, and that's about how I'm going to have to hope it goes. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope you come back for the next one. I'll see y'all later. Bye.